After striking out 6 batters over 8 scoreless innings, he probably could have pitched the complete full game, but Boone gave him a break. They got a 1-2-3 inning in the 9th. Anthony Volpe and Juan Soto each slugged their 2nd home run of the year with a 3-run shot in the bottom of the 4th. Alex Verdugo also drove in a run for the Yanks. New York is now leading the AL East at 9-2 and will continue its 3-game set tonight at Yankee Stadium. That 9-2 record has them atop Major League Baseball. The Mets came from behind to top the Atlanta Braves 8-7 in their series opener at Truist Park. New York is now 3rd alone in the NL East at 4-6 and will continue their 4-game set tonight. WIBX 950 News Time is 7:11. I want to tell you that Revive Softwave Therapy on Genesee Street in Utica could be the answer to your pain problems. That's right. Whatever you're dealing with, whether it be back pain, shoulder pain, hamstring pain, elbow pain, TMJ, Achilles tendinopathy, neuropathy itself, whatever ails you, it's very possible that Softwave Therapy can help. The procedure averages 10 to 15 minutes, but maybe longer depending on treatment area and diagnosis. It works when a gel is applied to the surface area of the body part that's being treated. The applicator produces high-speed sound waves or pulses as the clinician moves around the treatment area. During therapy, communication with the provider is necessary to identify treatment areas and monitor progress. So, in the instance of my foot and ankle, I would tell the person, Dr. Tim or Dr. Nate or Monique or whoever was working on my foot that day, hey, yeah, over a little bit to the left, a little over to the right. Oh, there it is. You can actually feel the high-speed sound waves working on your inflamed, impacted area. It is a quick treatment, and you will love it. It's non-invasive, no anesthesia or numbing cream needed, no side effects, same-day procedure, and the results last. So if you want an alternative to the pain pills or those pain injections, which will only mask the pain and make it worse in some cases, why don't you give Dr. Tim and his team a try at Revive Softwave Therapy on Genesee Street. ReviveUtica.com, that's the website, ReviveUtica.com, and if you call them at 315-725-8427 and let them know that we sent you from the Keeler Show, you'll get Discovery Days, which is a great deal on your initial consultation and treatment. You don't have to accept this is just the way it is any longer. Let the healing begin with a Revive Softwave Therapy on Genesee Street in Utica.
Okay, I want to tell you that for some reason, our YouTube feed just... the computer just crashed, so
it wasn't all the songs that we were playing.
You never know. So there is a part 2 that is up. So it's called Keeler Live Stream Tuesday, April 9th, part 2. So
people may have to go a little bit further.
You're gonna have to search a little bit to find it. And sorry about that. I don't know why it happened. It just crashed. Okay, we'll get to that. Also, want to tell you River Hills Properties. If you had a chance to see their show over the weekend, there'll be a brand new one this weekend called Sold in Upstate New York. It'll air 2 p.m. on Saturday on WPNY, and then Sundays, 8 a.m. and 11:30 p.m. on Fox 33 TV. So check it out. You saw it?
It was very well done.
I'm excited about it. I think they're doing a great job.
Naturals. That Bill and Robin.
They are naturals at it, and they're naturals at real estate. If you're looking to buy or sell a home, if you're looking to sell, why wouldn't you list? And right now, why wouldn't you list with River Hills? Right now, it is a time where the housing stock is low, so you end up getting top dollar for your home. It's incredible at what homes are going for today because people are in need, and they can't wait any longer.
Yeah, that's right. Bill and Robin have established the precedent of pricing it to sell for what they believe you will get it, what you would get for it. And if it happens to be a little bit lower than you were hoping for, odds are it's competitive price, and odds are that will go up because of the demand. So you want to trust the pricing policy of River Hills Property.
People offering over the asking price all the time right now. It's incredible. River Hills is the number one independent real estate agency in the area, number two if you include the independents. The TV program airs every Saturday and Sunday, and episode 2 will air this weekend, Sold in Upstate New York. River Hills Properties, they have offices in Barneville, Little Falls, Rome, and Utica. Online, it's riverhillspropertiesllc.com. Call 315-896-1009. Remember, nobody sells homes like River Hills Properties.
From Away is a powerful celebration of humanity. Go see this gem of a musical. Come From Away.
April 16th and 17th at the Stanley Theater. For tickets, visit BroadwayUtica.org. Ready for a smoother, safer ride? Look to Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair, your trusted tire experts. Let Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair get your vehicle ready for spring. Visit Tallman's to get your free alignment check and take advantage of their spring tire rotation and four-wheel balance special for only $39.99. Get the snow off now and save with an instant rebate on Bridgestone and Firestone tires in April, up to $100 off. Visit them in Utica, Yorkville, Rome, and Herkimer, or schedule an appointment online at TallmansTire.com.
A healthy weight, more energy, and smooth, regular bowel movements. Three things everyone strives for.
It's me, Chuck Norris. There's one really important thing we don't talk about enough. Our health. Achy joints, digestive issues, weight gain, and fatigue. We're told these are normal signs of aging. So working with a team of health experts, we came up with Morning Kick.
Morning Kick is a revolutionary formula combining 10 different supplements in one. Probiotics that help you lose weight. Prebiotics for digestion. Superfoods for muscles and joints. And several of the most powerful anti-aging supplements on earth. It'll help you feel youthful, energized, focused, and help manage stress.
Anybody can achieve great health regardless of their age.
Go to roundhouseprovisions.com. Use code SUPPORT or text SUPPORT to 511-511 and claim 40% off today.
Every purchase comes with our 90-day money-back guarantee.
Text SUPPORT to 511-511. Morning Kick.
These statements have not been evaluated by the FDA. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. Tax fees may apply.
Keep your income tax return. You worked hard for it. At Mattress Express, we're not only going to pay the sales tax for you, but qualified customers get zero down and up to 5 years interest-free on select luxury king and queen sets like the Smart Bed by Instant Comfort, Posh and Lavish, and more.
Ready for a smoother, safer ride? Look to Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair, your trusted tire experts. Let Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair get your vehicle ready for spring. Visit Tallman's to get your free alignment check and take advantage of their spring tire rotation and four-wheel balance special for only $39.99. Get the snow off now and save with an instant rebate on Bridgestone and Firestone tires in April, up to $100 off. Visit them in Utica, Yorkville, Rome, and Herkimer, or schedule an appointment online at TallmansTire.com.
Spring into summer with massive savings from Liverpool Pool and Spa, your headquarters for summer fun. Now through Memorial Day, save up to 75% on all backyard essentials while supplies last. Shop patio furniture, pool chemicals, pool toys, floats, and games. Plus, now is the perfect time to become an LPS Rewards member and receive 2x the LPS Rewards cash for every dollar spent on any chemical purchases. Stop by our East Dominic Street location in Rome today. And remember, don't just dream it, live it.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online at hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation to determine the ED medication that's best for you. Discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and a range of treatment options, including trusted generic alternatives to the name brands, at up to 95% off. ED is personal, and at Hims, so is treating it. Just go to hims.com/joy and get connected to a licensed medical provider online for free. With zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy for your free online visit, hims.com/joy.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online at hims.com/radio. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation to determine the ED medication that's best for you. Discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and a range of treatment options, including trusted generic alternatives to the name brands. at up to 95% off. ED is personal, and at Hims, so is treating it. Just go to hims.com/radio and get connected to a licensed medical provider online for free. With zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/radio. That's hims.com/radio for your free online visit. hims.com/radio.
Hey, everybody in upstate New York. I don't know where in upstate New York, but thanks for listening to the Keeler Show. Never met this man. Don't know why I'm telling everybody to listen, but thank you very much. By the way, this is Larry David from Curb Your Enthusiasm. I have nothing else really to say to you, but I thank you for listening to me tell you to listen to this man, Bill Keeler, on WIBX.
This is Keeler on WIBX 950, online at WIBX950.com.
The official coffee of the Keeler in the Morning program is Daylight Donuts in New Hartford. Daylight Donuts, everything from, and you know, the pumpkin lattes are still around. You can still get that pumpkin spice at Daylight Donuts. Coffee, espresso, lattes, iced coffee, breakfast sandwiches, and bagels and more. I love the croissant, egg, bacon, and cheese, or egg, sausage, and cheese. And the coffee is Seattle's best. Daylight Donuts in New Hartford with that drive-thru that's lightning fast, in and out, and you are on your way. Mike asked this morning, I wonder if that soft wave therapy could help Andrew with his damaged eyes.
I think it may. Here's
Dr. Kent Hall. Doc, good morning.
Good morning. How you doing this morning?
Good. So I'd like to ask you, did you get any great photos of the, because that was not easy, photographing the eclipse?
Yeah, so I think I took like 650 pictures.
Yeah.
Because I had a couple cameras set up, and I had them set to
There's one of the docs. Shoot multiple ones. That, I got to put
showing,
that up.
Doc, I'm showing Bill the one you sent me this morning. This is up from his view vantage point at Tupper Lake.
Right.
And was it pretty clear up there, Doc?
Yeah, so it was, you know, it was cloudy, you know, when I got there about noon, but it started to clear off, and by the time that the eclipse started, it was essentially clear. And then the clouds started to come back in right before the eclipse ended, so right around 4 o'clock or so.
Yeah, we were in Old Forge, and the clouds moved in just at the wrong time. But it still was a spectacular view.
You got the Tupper Lake clouds.
If you can send me that, I'd like to put that up on, as long as Doc's okay with it, put that up on YouTube for people to see. That's a beautiful photo, Doc.
Well, thank you.
And how did you feel when the eclipse happened? I felt like it was kind of emotional.
Yeah, it was really kind of surreal. What I really noticed about it was that, you know, until the sun was about 90% covered, it was almost like, you know, there wasn't any change in the light. I'm sure there was. But
I felt the same way. Yeah. Yeah. It's like.
But then when it went from 10% to zero, it was like, wow, that changed a lot.
It's funny because, like, right around that 10% point, we were with a group of people, and I'm like, this is like completely oversold. I mean, here we are in the center, right in the midst of totality, and this isn't even dark. And I swear, it's like almost a switch went off. It just began to get dark very quickly. And I remember we had the, I believe it was the scientists who were in here from SUNY Poly, and they're like, well, it's not going to be like a switch goes off. It was pretty close, Doc, don't you think?
Yeah, it was a dramatic change over, you know, and again, you know, from 10% to totality was probably a total of what, 6 or 7 minutes, something like that. So it changed quickly. And what I was listening for was, you know, the people talk about that you'll hear the, you know, the crickets come out and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I didn't hear that up there, then again, it may be because the crickets aren't out yet. So
I wonder, so we were on the water, and we were on one of the We were on, I don't know which creek it is or lake it is, but we're off one of the main lakes up there in Old Fort. Sorry, I don't know more about this. Anyway, and the water became completely calm. Like, it looked like glass. And it wasn't that way before the eclipse. And for a while after, it was. But then all of a sudden, you saw the ripples in the water again. I wonder why that occurred.
Yeah, you know, I noticed the same thing. I was also, you know, around a body of water. It was a small pond up there. And, you know, what I noticed was the same thing. It was like there was some wind and some ripples, and then it went away. And I don't know if the temperature change, you know, causes the wind to change or what, but it was definitely not noticeable.
It was, the water looked like glass. It was just really so incredible. But that was, it was while the eclipse was going on, but after it ended, it went back to normal, you know, like a normal current going through.
So, Doc, you know, we can't go through a conversation with you without a copay-free opinion here. I think I may have stared in the sun too long. I think my eyes might have been burned out. What's your opinion on how long you'd have to be looking at the sun for it to do long-term damage?
Well, it's different. You know, there is no, unfortunately, there is no set time.
Oh boy.
What I have seen is usually it's about, you know, about three minutes or so.
Oh, okay.
Of looking at it. And the symptoms that you get there, you get a headache, but that's really just because your eyes are trying to focus and they're having a hard time. Really, it's blurred vision. And sometimes lines will look like they're bent. You know, something that should be straight looks like it's bent.
Okay.
The good news is that, the cells in your retina, the rods and the cones, mostly the rods, are can actually regenerate.
Oh, good. Okay.
But they can take some time, and depending upon if you actually got a lot, then it's not, then they may not regenerate completely. So, but usually it's, you know, if I was going to give a number, I would say that if you were looking at it for less than 3 minutes, then the chance of having permanent damage is actually pretty small.
Oh, good. Okay. Because
it's in your head, Andrew.
Literally. No, but, you know, there's a couple of times I didn't have the certified glasses. And, you know, I really wasn't in a position to be prepared to sit and watch it. But there was, you know, I was at my house up in North Utica, and it wasn't the totality. It wasn't in the path of totality. But I was able to catch a glimpse when it was behind the clouds and when it was a little bit covered, when there was some totality. So I don't think it was too bad. I did throw on some polarized sunglasses at one point, which I understand is not a protector, but I think I might be okay. But I can see where the damage would occur if you were to be staring for quite a long time. I mean,
imagine if you, and Doc, correct me if I'm wrong. Imagine if you were able to, without tearing up and closing your eyes, stare into the sun for 3 minutes.
Yeah, I don't think you could.
Right? And that's really what we're talking about here, is that, unless I'm wrong, is that it's almost as if your eyes are protected from the actual brightness, yet you're still staring into it, and it still can cause the damage. Is that correct?
Yeah, so that's exactly right. The, you know, the human body, the sensations that we feel, actually, to a very great extent, are protective. So when you stare at the sun, your eyes hurt. You look away because staring at the sun is bad for your eyes. the issue comes when you get something like, you know, partial cloud cover, and you're looking at the eclipse, but it's not total, because then it doesn't hurt as much. You know?
Right.
In fact, it may not hurt at all, but you're still getting those ultraviolet radiation, which is what actually causes the damage to the eyes. It's not the brightness. The brightness is actually what keeps us from looking at it.
Right.
But it's the ultraviolet radiation that actually does the damage to the eyes.
Which is probably why you can get on an overcast day, you can get a sunburn.
Right, exactly. Yeah, right. Exactly, yeah. Right.
So, but what was very interesting is when it reached totality, your glasses really didn't work anymore. So you could take off the glasses and actually look at it once you reach that point of totality. By the way, right now I'm going to, if you're watching on YouTube, I am going to show you Dr. Hall's picture. It's up on YouTube right now.
Which is awesome.
It is the picture of totality. You're at Tupper Lake, you said?
Yeah, just outside of Tupper Lake, yeah.
And it is a perfect photo. It is really, really something to check out. And it's up on YouTube right now. Very, very, very interesting. And it was interesting how the temperature went down, how it really did. If you were in totality, Doc, it got dark. And how quickly it got dark. It was really something.
Yeah, it got dark and it got cold. You are absolutely right. And the good thing about totality, you're absolutely right. You can't see anything with the, you know, approved solar glasses on, but you don't need them during totality because the moon, when you're in the path of totality, the moon actually blocks the damaging rays, enough of the damaging rays that you're not going to injure your eyes. But as soon as the sun starts to come back, you need to put them back on.
All right. Well, just a really spectacular day. If you had a chance to be able to take time and get somewhere to see it, and even if you saw it in an area like that was not in totality, there still was much to be seen, and it did get darker. I think Richard said he felt like his house, he had to turn lights on in his house because it got dark in his house. We heard from him this morning. But boy, if you could get to a place, and, you know, here we are, such a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, get to a place like Tupper Lake or Old Forge or Speculator or wherever, where you could enjoy that totality, boy, what an experience it really was.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we're not going to get another one for a long time.
For a long time.
Well, I'm just glad that the doc was on with us this morning to assure me that my eyes are not fried.
Yeah, I think you're a little on the paranoid side.
I can imagine how somebody would, over long periods of time, it could damage it. Because even in the little bit brief moment that I looked up, you did feel a bit of discomfort and pain. And even still today, just like, you know, a little bit.
You are?
Yeah. It wasn't 3 minutes, but.
Yeah. I think Andrew's had a few sugar pills this morning or something.
Too much coffee.
All right, Doc, we appreciate it. And I put your photo back up there right now. It is really something to be seen. It's up on our website. Actually, it's up on YouTube right now if you want to check it out. Dr. Hall's unbelievable ability to take pictures, and that's pretty cool. All right, Doc, thank you so much.
Thanks, everybody. Have a great day. It looks like we're going to get a beautiful day today, and then, unfortunately, we're back to the April showers. So.
By the way, is it okay today to look into the sun and stare there for like 3 minutes? Andrew would like to know.
Yeah,
you
know, now that the eclipse is gone.
People are going to do what they're going to do. So.
Yeah, you're right. All right, Doc, thank you so much. Have a great day.
Thanks, everybody. Please be safe.
Dr. Kent Hall from, formerly with Wynn Hospital, so. All right, let me remind you, last night, huge win for the women. What a game. They had actually an attendance record set last night. The most people ever to watch a game at the Adirondack Bank Center. And they win in overtime. In that fourth period, the overtime period, the U.S. won. And, man, did they put the gas on when it came to offense. Boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, it was a game and a half. And then UConn, it looked like Purdue gave them a bit of a run towards the end, but not really. It was all UConn through the second half. Here's the call that came down. UConn Huskies beating Purdue for the NCAA Men's Championship.
It is a UConn coronation. The Huskies make history. National champions. Number one lives up to the billing. They defeat Purdue 75-60. They've done it again.
They've done it again. Some comments. Mike says, not to be a spoiler, but the finale of Curb was perfect. They did the whole trial thing correctly as opposed to, let's see what he says here. It stops right at that point.
Well, don't spoil it.
They did the whole, as opposed to what happened at the finale of Seinfeld. Oh, okay.
I think Jerry was, the promos had Jerry Seinfeld.
I see. There. Right. See, now I'm not a Seinfeld fan, so I guess I'll have to read up and find out what
You
what
may
happened
have to
there.
Go back and watch. It's on Netflix now. It's pretty funny.
You mean the last episode of Seinfeld, the season finale?
Never watched.
They got arrested.
They did?
Yeah.
Okay, they went to court?
Yeah, yes. They had Jackie Childs.
All right, well, then apparently there's a mirror. There's a bit of a...
Yes, it's a...
The Curb Your Enthusiasm final episode pays tribute to Seinfeld. And then one more before I break. We'll do the free money question. Wayne, good morning.
Hey, guys, what's up?
Hey, Wayne, good morning.
Over the weekend, they had baseball tryouts for... I think it was for minor and little league, and I took my son over there at the... It's on Culver Ave, across from the New Stewards.
East on the east side.
Yeah, and you know what? The mayor was there, which I was very surprised. But I didn't. When I go along, I mind my own business. But I heard his voice, and he's got this voice that you just don't forget. And I looked back, and I said, "Your voice." I said, "You're the mayor, right?" And it was him. But it was pretty cool that he took part in that. I really didn't think he would be. You know, I mean, it was nice to see him there.
I had a just any experience I've had up to this point with this mayor, I think he is doing a tremendous job. I really do.
Exactly what I told him.
Yeah, I think he's getting out and he's talking to people. He is
even in the midst of a very difficult tax increase, he's still out there. He should be.
He's facing the music, and
it isn't his fault.
And I do think he's. You know, I think he's handling it properly. So let's see where it all goes. But
I want to tell you a couple things before you guys go throwing me away here. I want well, I know how quick you guys got to go to commercials.
Yeah, right.
So, we do.
Yeah. So we're sitting there, right? We're watching baseball tryouts, and you look over towards Stewards, and there's like, I don't know, four motorcycles at a time, the crotch rockets, and they got guys doing wheelies and speeding down Culver Ave, and here's the mayor dead center.
Wow.
These guys are doing, they're popping wheelies right straight down Culver Ave, and then about another 10 minutes goes by, and they're popping more wheelies right straight down and right in front of them like they're doing it for them.
So how did the mayor handle that?
I'm sure he's probably sitting there going, why these, you know?
What's he going to do?
I'll have to do something about that at a later date.
Right.
I don't know what they could do to stop that. What are they going to do, put up spike strips?
I don't know. Good question. All right. Well, all it takes is one of those wheelies for somebody to go over all the way, and then all of a sudden
and
the
unfortunately,
fun's over.
There was an accident involving a motorcycle on Broad Street yesterday. Luckily, the Utica police have released information that indicates not life-threatening injuries, although they are severe. So you just got to be careful on those things.
All right,
Bill, okay, I'll let you. No. It was from Welsh Bush Road almost to Rucker. These guys can hang it.
Yeah.
They're like holding it up and just going straight through full bore.
Wow, that's a talent. There's no doubt about it.
Idiotic talent, but
it is. All right, Wayne. Thank you, man.
Thanks, guys.
Have a great day. Got a break. Before we do, though, we're looking for how much money this morning. Are you running with this morning on our free money question from Hobika? I realize that Hobika's gotten to you.
$100.
Oh, yeah. $100, and you're looking for caller number what?
Eight.
Eighth caller, $100, and here's your number. This week, the number, and next week will change, but this week the number remains at 315-723-3824. 315-723-3824. You're looking for caller number 8. And a chance to win cash from Hobika right now at WIBX.
Lightly, you want industry standards met with affordable options and a crew who knows how important a sound roof is to you and your family. Dennis Spadula & Sons Roofing is your hometown roofers with deep roots in our community. Spadula Roofers specialize in residential roofing projects. They're a GAF-certified Master Elite Roofing contractor who keeps their standards above the rest. Call 315-733-1564 to find out more about their Roofs for Troops mail-in rebate. Dennis Spadula & Sons Roofing, your hometown roofers.
Fraudulent tax returns due identity theft increased by 30% in 2023. If you're in a bind this tax season, LifeLock can help. Their U.S.-based restoration specialists are dedicated to helping solve identity theft issues, and all plans are backed by the $1 Million Protection Package, which means if you lose money because of identity theft, LifeLock will reimburse you up to the limits of your plan. Help protect your information with LifeLock. Go to LifeLock.com and save up to 25% your first year with my name, Clay, as your promo code.
I found a checking account that's just as interesting as my life. With America's new high-rate checking, I earn one of the highest rates available and still have access to my money when I need it. I even get paid a day early with direct deposit. AmeriCue connected me with more than a checking account. Visit AmeriCue.org to open a high-rate checking today. Membership eligibility is required, insured by NCUA.
Ready for a smoother, safer ride? Look to Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair, your trusted tire experts. Let Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair get your vehicle ready for spring. Visit Tallman's to get your free alignment check and take advantage of their spring tire rotation and four-wheel balance special for only $39.99. Get those off now and save with an instant rebate on Bridgestone and Firestone tires in April, up to $100 off. Visit them in Utica, Yorkville, Rome, and Herkimer, or schedule an appointment online at TallmansTire.com.
Hi, this is Bill Cole from Gates Cole Insurance with exciting news. We are expanding with a couple of new offices in our area. One new location is North Country Estates Insurance in Lowellville. They are another independent insurance agency that takes pride in making customers happy and fits our culture at Gates Cole perfectly. Here is William Schaub from the newest Gates Cole agency, North Country Estates Insurance in Lowellville.
Working with us as an independent agent with this many companies, we will often call our clients and say, we're going to reduce your premium if you like. We have the companies that do well in New York and specifically this area. The coverages that we provide are commercial and personal insurance. That's the home, the auto, ATV, motorcycle. There's nothing more fun than taking care of a customer and being able to tell them that we're able to save them some money.
Proudly representing Finger Lakes Fire and Casualty Company of Trumansburg, New York. Gates Cole Insurance will take care of you.
Why do so many dogs suffer from weight issues, skin problems, messy poops, and low energy? It could be the popular dog food you put in their bowl each day.
Cody was sleeping a lot, wasn't playing.
She was very lethargic and not moving around.
Dry kibble just wasn't cutting it.
That's why, after more than 45 years of experience of helping dogs make complete health turnarounds, veterinarian Dr. Marty created Nature's Blend. It's a freeze-dried raw dog food made with wholesome ingredients like premium meats, seeds, vegetables, and fruit. And once dog parents switch their pups to Nature's Blend, the results can be astounding.
She's got her energy back. She's running around like she did like 5 years ago.
Miraculously, she's just feeling all around better. She's like a new dog. Thank you, Dr. Marty.
Get your dog started today and save up to 54% off Nature's Blend. Plus, receive a free pack of our best-selling beef liver dog treats. Go to drmartypets.com/deal or text DEAL to 511-511. Text DEAL to 511-511. All dogs are unique. Your dog's results can and will vary. Message and data rates may apply.
Keeler. Do you know how many people died so you could have the right to vote?
You gotta vote. Haven't you seen the Rock the Vote stuff or Pop Daddy's Vote or Die?
All anyone's talking about is this election. It's ruining Twitter.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. The Keeler Show.
Hey, if you're watching on YouTube this morning, we want you to know that for some reason everything crashed at 7 a.m. Mm-hmm. So there are two parts up there. There's part one that goes from 6 to 7. And part number two, which is live right now. If that makes sense. So just make that note for YouTube. There you go. All right, it's time now for Hobika's free money question of the day. It's a chance for somebody to walk away a winner of dough, cash, as we spend our final few days in the basement. It's been longer than a month we've been down here. And
I'm kind of liking it.
We found ways to make this work, and I think we kind of like it. Although looking at the new studio, it's very exciting.
Yeah, it'll be a nice chair to sit in.
I'm gonna kind of be out of my element when I go back there.
You are.
How's your booth looking? Is it renovated there in there too?
He was giving me an update on it yesterday. It's looking nice.
The other thing that's nice is we've always had like three lines. Here in this studio, we have one, which is difficult. Maybe two, maybe three if we're all using each other's cell phones. But in the studio, we'll have six lines. I like that.
I don't know what the heck I'm going
to
do.
You're going to be very excited
with
that.
You're going to have to work your fingers.
Bob is in Frankfurt right now. Hi, Bob. Good morning.
Good morning, everybody. How are you?
Good. You ready to go?
Well, I got a quick comment for you. I agree with you with Seinfeld. Without Kramer and George, he would have been nothing.
Yeah, I guess
he's not a funny man.
Yeah. Oh, you don't like Seinfeld.
What's that?
You don't. You're not a fan of Seinfeld. That's really what I would say.
He's not funny at all.
Yeah.
You're saying that without Kramer, George made the show.
It would not have been a show.
Yeah. Yeah. I think you're right. I just never watched it. I think it had a lot to do with it was a, even though it wasn't about stand-up comedy, it was based around that and.
Yeah.
I just ran comedy clubs, and I'm like, oh, my God, I can't do another comedy show. And that's how I felt anyway. So.
I had to say that before we got going here.
Fair enough, Bob. Now, you know how this works. You have 7 seconds to answer the question and get your answer in before the buzzer goes off. Are you ready?
I am.
All right, here is your question. And it's apropos. It fits right where we are after the big women's win last night over Canada. At the Adirondack Bank Center, here's the question. What was the first ever hockey puck made of? Ready and go.
Coal.
You're going to go with coal.
Oh, I know this one.
Was it made of coal?
So close.
Andrew.
Cow dung.
Cow dung?
Yeah.
You think it was?
Yeah, frozen cow dung.
I did hear that. But I have listed here stone. Be honest.
So wouldn't coal be a correct answer? It's a form of a stone?
I don't think so. I don't think that fits.
Oh, come on.
I'd love to. Believe me. I would love to.
Mike has got a lot of money.
I would love to. But you know how that goes. All right. Listen, I'm gonna give you to Davey, and we're going to hook you up with the food, what's it called again?
The all-in-one card.
The all-in-one card.
What's the fun card?
The answer
is stone.
Stone.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah. All right. Stand by, and Davey's going to hook you up. By the way, that all-in-one food and fun card is a $25 gift card, and it's good at Aquavino, Babes, Cookies Q and Creamery, any of the anything going on at the Odd right now, as a matter of fact. Taylor and the Cook, Aquavino.
Concessions catching an IIHF hockey.
Did you
game?
See also that there is a there's a VIP section that you can buy into when you go to these games, and they've completely transformed the 72 Tavern and Grill.
Oh, really?
It's unbelievable.
Nice.
And it's like a lounge in there with TVs and a bar and. It's where you can go and just hang and watch games all day long. It's pretty darn cool.
So Big Honey and Hecla weighing in on the tournament saying, I would believe this women's hockey is the biggest thing to hit Utica since when Abraham Lincoln stopped here to, well, relieve himself.
All right, the correct answer, you were right, is the first hockey pucks were made. I used... A listener, Donna, this morning.
Yeah, that's where I got my
actually. She actually gave me the question, but it was not. My answer was stone. The correct answer was cow dung.
Yeah.
And leather liver pads. So that sounds fun.
Yeah. Those poor animals.
Coal, unfortunately, was not even close. But a good answer. I think that was a pretty good answer. With people out there with comments. Last night, as we mentioned, the USA team, Team USA, with a huge win. This thing was a defensive battle, but an offensive battle as well, as they were all, you know, just fighting to get a goal in.
Yeah.
A lot of shots on goal, a lot of fast action. I mean, you look at these two teams. Like, I watched, was it China and Japan? And Japan. And I just have to say, things were moving very slowly. And then you see the U.S. get on the ice, and it is lightning fast. And then you see the U.S. and Canada going at it. And, I mean, is it just me? Because it seems like it's a really, really fast game.
It is fast, and there's no doubt about it that these are the two powerhouses in this tournament right now. And just to give you, I'm looking at the Adirondack Bank Center Facebook page, and they put out a stat. A game of inches, all time at the Women's Worlds, okay, between Canada and U.S., 34 games played, 17 wins, 17 losses each. Goals for and against, 98 in Canada's favor, 97 in the U.S.'s favor. Gold medals, Canada 12, U.S. 10. Canada is 12-9 all time versus USA in gold medal games. So these two teams in the history of the Women's Worlds
perfectly
championship,
tied.
Very tight.
Except the U.S.
They have just a little bit of an edge on Canada.
Took the edge.
Yeah,
and
Canada has the edge overall.
Here's,
but in this tournament, U.S. looking really good.
Here's the problem with that is if they keep flopping back and forth, oh boy, because that gold medal game is probably going to be the U.S. versus Canada.
I was just going to say that on Sunday.
Yeah, next week. All right, we had asked the other day when it comes to the playoffs.
Playoffs
in AHL, NHL, or in this, there are no shootouts in the playoffs. The overtime periods are the same as the regular periods of a full game of hockey. And then Ross Bartel had some really interesting tidbits on the Women's World Games that I wanted to throw out this morning. Clarkson University Women's Hockey Program has produced 8 players taking part in the tournament, 2 of which are on the current Clarkson roster. Wynn and Harmon are on USA. Wynn is from Rochester, and she had 2 goals the other night against Switzerland. That was really a great start. Gosling, Fast, Shelton, Ambrose, Rattray on Canada. Pezlova on Czechia. 23 players on Team USA, 10 of which play in the PWHL, the Women's Hockey League, Professional Women's Hockey League. The other 13 are playing on multiple U.S. college hockey teams. I mean, this team you're watching here, actually, both Canada and the U.S., the teams you're watching are superstars.
Yeah.
They really,
the
really are.
The best of the best.
23 players on Canada, 20 play in the PWHL, 3 are playing U.S. college hockey right here in Central New York, 1 at Clarkson, 1 at Colgate, and 1 at St. Lawrence. All interesting little factoids from Ross this morning, who's quite a hockey expert on his own. Other comments here this morning to pop in, and I know, Andrew, you have some as well. Donna said, no, not a stone, frozen cow dung. You're right, Donna. Thank you. Julie, her family chickens were roosting during the eclipse.
Oh, really?
Is that what happens? Yeah. So now that it gets dark and then the sun comes up.
Well, my brother-in-law and my sister have a little farm, and they have chickens. My mom was talking to my sister last night, and she was home for the eclipse. The chickens went inside when it got dark, and then after, they came back out.
And then
there was
they
a
came
ton of
out.
Eggs left
yeah,
behind.
Yeah, interesting. And then they came back out.
So I got a dilemma real
okay,
quick.
Okay, what is
so Davy's Dilemma.
Your
another
dilemma.
Edition of Davy's Dilemma.
It's not nothing major.
Yeah, yeah.
So we have a fire stick that we use on one of our TVs.
Is that a brand, fire stick?
Amazon fire stick.
Okay, all right.
It's like the Amazon Apple TV.
Yep, yep.
So
far and
we have Peacock. And I went to use it over the weekend to put on a program. And it shows the users' names and you can click on.
Yeah.
So when I go to the username, it gets a gray screen. So that, and I, is there something wrong with it? When I click on the user and then I.
Sometimes I find, I don't know how the Amazon Fire Stick works, but sometimes I find that if you unplug it.
I did unplug it and
over,
waited 15, 20 seconds and then plugged it back in. Nothing happened.
I don't
might
know.
Be your Wi-Fi.
Yeah, but I have Wi-Fi. I use it on my phone, and it worked.
Yeah. So you're able to use it on your phone.
Yes.
Okay.
So the Fire Stick's just not connecting?
It's not connecting. I used it on Saturday afternoon to watch a program. Then I went to put it up on Sunday, and it didn't work.
Yeah, okay. I have never used that that brand, so I don't know. I don't know anything about it. Maybe somebody out there
I figured
does.
I'd just run it by you guys.
A man in, how much time do I have? Not much.
Two minutes.
I got a couple minutes. A man in Decatur, Illinois is a man with some serious lower body strength. Listen to this. On April 5th, he set out to break a record for the most squats done in a 24-hour period. Now, a lot of times these Guinness records seem to be so stupid today. Although the most brilliant of all was the world's largest jelly donut, and that still exists. It's still a record that is ours here, and we broke back in the 1990s. Pretty cool. But this guy is impressive. Beginning at 5 a.m., Pirano commenced to squatting, and one full day later ended up shattering the previous record, which was 1,000. He squatted in 24 hours. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how he did this without something keeping him going. 26,100 squat thrusts.
Get out.
Yeah. To accomplish his mission, Pirano forced himself to take a 30-second break every 22 squats, as well as making time for longer breaks through the day. He also had some help from energy drinks and carb-loaded snacks along the way. It was all done to raise money and awareness for their Horizon Center in Marion County, which provides resources for adults with mental disabilities. But he did pretty well there.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's pretty darn cool. 26.
What the heck is that?
I don't know what that is. I'll try later, okay? You just sit there and be quiet.
Skynet.
26,000. Okay, thank you. 26,100 squat thrusts.
That is impressive. I don't know that I could even do 26.
I don't know if you're looking at something else that's very impressive, and it is today's weather forecast. Boy, it'd be great if it was yesterday. I mean, imagine 10 degrees warmer, full sunshine. That's where we're going to be today. We're talking about temperatures today with sunshine. Full sun, they say, and temperatures going to almost 75 degrees today. It's going to be a beautiful day. But then tonight we begin with rain, and it looks like rain right on until Saturday, maybe even into Sunday. And it'll be a little cooler, but expect a lot of rain coming after today.
Look to Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair, your trusted tire experts. Let Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair get your vehicle ready for spring. Visit Tallman's to get your free alignment check and take advantage of their spring tire rotation and four-wheel balance special for only $39.99. Get the snow off now and save with an instant rebate on Bridgestone and Firestone tires in April, up to $100 off. Visit them in Utica, Yorkville, Rome, and Herkimer, or schedule an appointment online at tallmanstire.com.
Adirondack Home Furniture wants you to get your savings in full eclipse mode at their Total Eclipse Sale. Don't miss out on stellar deals that are out of this world. It's their best prices of the year. Take an extra 15% off all in-stock and special orders and 10% off all clearance items. Adirondack Home Furniture is fully stocked for this event with merchandise arriving daily. With free delivery on purchases over $1,000 and a knowledgeable staff, you'll have your stellar home in no time. Adirondack Home Furniture has a large line of quality USA-made furniture from top manufacturers. Their salespeople are non-commission, which means you enjoy a relaxing, non-stressful experience. Stop in today to Adirondack Home Furniture and check out their stellar deals with their Total Eclipse Sale going on now. Living rooms, dining rooms, bedrooms, and more, all at the best prices of the year. Adirondack Home Furniture at Riverside Center in North Utica or at AdirondackHomeFurniture.com.
Fraudulent tax returns due identity theft increased by 30% in 2023. If you're in a bind this tax season, LifeLock can help. Their U.S.-based restoration specialists are dedicated to helping solve identity theft issues, and all plans are backed by the $1 Million Protection Package, which means if you lose money because of identity theft, LifeLock will reimburse you up to the limits of your plan. Help protect your information with LifeLock. Go to LifeLock.com and save up to 25% your first year with my name, Clay.
From the Stanley Theater Studio, WIBX 950 Utica Rome, W295 DI Utica Rome, your news, talk, and sports leader, a Town Square media station.
Don't let Trump win. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News. That's the gist of the special counsel's filing last night at the Supreme Court ahead of a hearing later this month in the criminal case against the former president over attempts to overturn the 2020 election. Jack Smith urging the justices to reject the Trump claim that he's immune from prosecution from actions taken while president. Meanwhile, in New York, an appeals judge rejected the former president's attempt to delay his first criminal trial. The jury questionnaire is also now ready.
Made up of 42 questions. While none ask about party affiliation or voting histories, they do include, have you, a relative, or a close friend ever worked or volunteered for any Trump group or organization? Have you ever attended a rally or campaign event for any anti-Trump group or organization? Jury selection begins next week in the trial for the former president accused of falsifying business records to cover up payments to adult film star Stormy Daniels before the 2016 election.
Fox's Kristen Goodwin. The U.S. went on the attack again in Yemen, again targeting Houthi militants who've been attacking ships in and around the Red Sea. The American strikes took out missiles and a ground control station for the Iran-backed militants, something Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin could be asked about at a Senate hearing next hour. Two parents will soon return to court in Michigan, facing up to 15 years in prison.
James and Jennifer Crumley were tried separately, but will be sentenced at the same hearing this morning. Their son, Ethan, killed four students at Oxford High School 3 years ago. He's serving life without parole. The Crumley parents are the first in the country to be tried and convicted for involuntary manslaughter linked to their son's actions.
Fox's Grinnell Scott. Connecticut does it again, repeating as college basketball national champions. Coach Dan Hurley credits players
that are willing to not make it about themselves and to be a part of a winning group and to go for all the championships.
UConn beat Purdue 75-60 on TBS. America's listening to Fox News.
Hi, I'm Martha Stewart. Every year, more than 4 million pets enter shelters here in the United States. My friends at American Humane have been helping animals since 1877. The goal is to ensure that pets have a safe shelter, especially during natural disasters. Adopting a shelter pet allows shelters to help more animals awaiting care. Please consider adopting today and take some time to learn more about American Humane's other work at AmericanHumane.org.
Hey everyone, it's Ted from Consumer Cellular, the guy in the orange sweater, and this is your wake-up call. If you're paying too much for wireless service, you don't have to keep having that nightmare. Consumer Cellular has the same fast, reliable coverage as the leading carriers for less. And for a limited time, new customers receive their second month free when they sign up and use promo code MONTHFREE by May 31st. So why keep spending more than you have to? Seriously, wake up and call 1-888-FREEDOM or visit ConsumerCellular.com.
Taxes, fees, and other third-party charges will apply. See website for additional details.
We mentioned Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin testifying this morning at a Senate hearing. It comes after his call last night with Israel's defense minister discussing the war in Gaza. As the U.S. opposes a new offensive, Israel says it has set a date for going after Hamas militants in Rafah, in an area of Gaza filled with Palestinian civilians. Now, Hamas has rejected Israel's latest ceasefire offer, but talks continue with National Security Communications Advisor John Kirby, hoping they can finally work out a deal.
Which would do a lot to ease the burden on the Gazan people and to help us improve that humanitarian assistance.
More than 300 trucks full of humanitarian aid entered Gaza on Sunday. That's the most in a single day since the war started. A first in the fight against climate change, an international court ruling. Europe's highest human rights court decided that its member nations have an obligation to protect citizens from the ill effects of climate change, but throughout another case that was aimed at forcing countries to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Somebody in Oregon is hoping to live happily ever after.
A person with a ticket matching all six Powerball numbers from Saturday's $1.3 billion jackpot has come forward to claim the prize, according to Oregon officials, who say their identity will not be revealed until after certain security measures and vetting has taken place. We do know the ticket was purchased at a Plaid pantry in the northeast part of Portland. The convenience store will get a $100,000 bonus for selling the fourth largest ticket in Powerball history. The winner can choose a lump sum of $621 $1 million or an annuity over 30 years, all before taxes. Players in Oregon, with few exceptions, are not allowed to remain anonymous. Lillian Wu, Fox News.
On Wall Street, stock futures have been mixed, not moving much, like yesterday when the Dow fell 11 points, but the NASDAQ rose 5. I'm Dave Anthony. This is Fox News.
Good morning, WIBX 950 News Time, 8:05. I'm Andrew Dermenio. Right now we're looking at temperatures close to 40 degrees. Your full weather forecast is coming up. This update brought to you by John's Mobile Home Parts and Accessories in Oriskany Falls. For all your mobile home needs, it's worth the trip. Go to johnsmobilehomeparts.com for more information. Well, Utica Police and Utica Fire Department responded to a scene of a serious motor vehicle accident yesterday at the intersection of Broad Street and Oriskany Street. That closed down traffic in both lanes for Oriskany Boulevard, Route 5S and Broad Street until about 9:30 p.m. Thankfully, the injuries sustained in the accident, while serious, do not appear to be life-threatening at this time. More information about the accident may be released at a later time. On Sunday, at approximately 7:50 p.m., Utica Police and Utica Fire units were dispatched to the Lillian Cooper Apartments regarding a physical domestic incident. Upon arrival, they located a victim who stated during the course of an argument, his ex-girlfriend repeatedly struck him in the head with her fists, and then, while doing so, grabbed a metal rod and hit him in the back of the head, causing a laceration. The victim was transported to Wynn Hospital regarding his injuries, and the female, 46-year-old Tasha Outen, was detained and ultimately transported to Utica Police Headquarters. At the conclusion of the investigation, Outen was charged with assault in the second degree, criminal possession of a weapon in the fourth degree. Several people, thousands as it turns out, turned up at the historic Thompson Park in Watertown to view the total solar eclipse yesterday. Among those were a group of students from Susan E. Wagner High School, who made the seven-hour drive for the celestial event. Totality hit at around 3:30 in the afternoon with cheers from the crowd of onlookers. Meanwhile, thousands traveled to Syracuse yesterday to see the total solar eclipse. This resulted in hotels being completely booked and long waits at area restaurants. It also caused major traffic jams throughout the day. Oneida County Sheriff Rob Maciol will join us in just a few minutes to give us a recap of how things went here locally as a result of the eclipse.
Can I give you my little recap? And it's small.
Recap away.
So we saw no additional traffic on Route 12.
Oh, that's good.
At all. Until we got up to Boonville, where the split came.
The split happens, yeah, to 28.
And it was unbelievable. So I think people were already, people who are going to Old Forge, except for us, and there was a steady traffic going to Old Forge, but the bulk of people were going into Boonville because they had some big events. So that's where it was kind of touch and go. And then around, I don't know, 5:30, we left Old Forge to come home, and we did run into some bumper-to-bumper traffic going about 30 miles an hour for about probably 6 or 7 miles, and then things lightened up.
Oh, that's good.
Once you got close to Boonville.
Well, like you said, it was like after leaving a concert.
It was. Yeah, it was no different than that. It really, really was. And we also stopped at the world-famous Wigwam for a bite to eat. And
love it there.
That place is really cool. So there you have my little traffic update. I feel like, and I saw a lot of people, a lot of school vans that were from colleges and, you know, schools that were from out of town. A lot of people coming up to the North Country. But
nice.
Yeah, it was
a lot of Space Force officials, NASA, all that.
But and downtown Old Forge was pretty busy. But I got to say, it's busier on 4th. It was busier on 4th of July. I think people feared the crowds and stayed away.
Yeah.
That's my opinion. And it's, you know, it's just my personal opinion. It's probably worth nothing.
No, it's worth something.
Would you like a forecast, Andrew?
You got one more story for you.
All right.
Then we can take the forecast. It's actually William Shatner. William Shatner Star Trek's Captain Kirk says Monday's solar eclipse captivated Americans across the nation. William Shatner said that people who experienced such an event before there was a scientific explanation must have been dumbstruck. He went on to explain the cosmic scale of the eclipse and why he was so excited to watch it unfold. Shatner viewed the eclipse with thousands of others at Indiana University.
I think I agree. Can you imagine, you know, 300 years ago?
Ah, it's Godzilla!
Yeah, you just wouldn't know what was going on. So
it is 8:10, and your weather is brought to you by Adirondack Home Furniture.
Here's the latest from the WIBS Weather Center. I'm Mike Johnson. Today, sunny skies with a high near 75. Tonight, partly cloudy, then showers, low 50 degrees. And tomorrow, through the rest of the week, rain, highs in the low to mid-60s. That's the latest. I'm Mike Johnson from the Weather Center on WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM.
The temperatures are like the Jeffersons. And moving on up, it's 43 degrees on our way to low 70s. Right? Clear skies at 8:10. In sports, well, it is official. UConn, the Huskies of UConn, are celebrating their second straight men's basketball national championship after blowing out Purdue 75-60 in the title game from Glendale. The Huskies rode a six-point lead into the half and never looked back. UConn is the first program to repeat since Florida did in 2007 and now has six NCAA tournament championships. It was a big night of hockey at the IIHF Women's World Championship from the Adirondack Bank Center yesterday. Germany beat Sweden 1-0. Finland beat Switzerland 5-2. And the big marquee matchup, the heavyweight bout, the big battle happened when the USA team beat Canada 1-0 in overtime from the Adirondack Bank Center, setting an Adirondack Bank Center attendance record at 4,017 people. They were selling standing room only tickets. Action continues today as Germany takes on China at 11. Czechia takes on Switzerland at 3 o'clock, and Japan will take on Denmark at 7 p.m. Tickets are available at EmpireStateTix.com. The Yankees, under the direction of Nasty Nestor Cortez, beat the Miami Marlins 7-0, beat up on them pretty good. Nasty Nestor got the striking out six batters over those eight scoreless innings. Anthony Volpe and Juan Soto each slugged their second home run of the year with a three-run shot in the bottom of the fourth. Alex Verdugo also drove in a run for the Yanks. New York is now leading the AL East at 9-2. I believe that's the best record in baseball right now. And they'll continue their three-game set tonight at Yankee Stadium. The Mets came from behind to top the Atlanta Braves 8-7 in their series opener at Truist Park. They are alone in third in the NL East at 4-6 and will continue their four-game set tonight. Meanwhile, the Knicks have been punished by the league. On Monday, the NBA fined the Knicks $25,000 for violating league injury reporting rules. New York failed to accurately disclose the status of Mitchell Robinson ahead of its game against the Raptors on March 27th. The Knicks listed Robinson as out on their initial injury report, and he went on to appear in the game. He played 12 minutes, scored 8 points, and collected a pair of rebounds. The Knicks are tied for third in the Eastern Conference at 46-32 and will visit the Bulls tonight. And one more for you. The Nets wrap up the home portion of the season tomorrow night. Brooklyn will be looking to bounce back from its recent loss when it hosts the Raptors at Barclays Center. Tomorrow's battle is also the final meeting of the season between the Nets and Raptors. Brooklyn has won two of the first three matchups. The Nets have the ninth worst record in the NBA at 31-48. WIBX 950 News Time, coming up on 8:14.
I want to tell you about Herkimer County. It's all unfolding in Herkimer County. Explore the Herkimer Diamond Mines. Savor the taste of Herkimer cheese, which is delicious. Or take a boat tour along the historic Erie Canal. Do you have a business or event to promote? Reach out to Herkimer County Development at their Facebook page. They're here to showcase the heart and soul of Herkimer County. Whether you're a local or just passing through, commit to Herkimer County, where history and commerce and beauty collide. It's happening in Herkimer County. And just around the corner, food truck season. Mondays, Herkimer Downtown Chowdown It begins on May 13th and goes through Labor Day. And Ilion Wednesdays, they have the Food Truck Frenzy that begins right around Memorial Day and runs through Labor Day as well. And Fridays, Heelpath Brewery in Frankfort has their events every Friday. And Paddle Fest coming to Old Forge May 17th through the 19th. Just some of what's happening. And remember, I believe June 12th, Enchanted Forest Water Safari opens. There's so much to do in Herkimer County.
Where the fun never stops. Bum, bum.
It's 8:15 at WIBX.
Sample sell-off is on at My Carl's. Floor samples of living room sets, dining sets, bedroom sets. Prices slashed up to 70% off. Only at My Carl's in the New Hartford Shopping Center.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential. But finding those people can be a major hassle. Unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. And right now you can try it for free at ZipRecruiter.com/radio. With ZipRecruiter, one click sends your job to hundreds of top job sites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. And the results speak for themselves. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/radio. That's ZipRecruiter.com/radio. ZipRecruiter.com/radio.
If you love them enough to turn off your music and pretend like their music is your music.
Ah, this is mommy's jam.
Then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
Let's play it again.
Check today at nhtsa.gov/the right seat. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Broadway's must-see musical takes you into the heart of the remarkable true story of 7,000 stranded passengers and a small town in Newfoundland that welcomed them. Come From Away. Hailed as the best of the year across North America, Come From Away is a powerful celebration of humanity. Go see this gem of a musical. Come From Away.
April 16th and 17th at the Stanley Theater. For tickets, visit BroadwayUtica.org.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online at hims.com/radio. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation to determine the ED medication that's best for you. Discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and a range of treatment options, including trusted generic alternatives to the name brands, at up to 95% off. ED is personal, and at Hims, so is treating it. Just go to hims.com/radio and get connected to a licensed medical provider online for free. With zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/radio. That's hims.com/radio for your free online visit, hims.com/radio.
The IRS is the most powerful collection agency on earth. And if you owe back taxes, the news isn't good. The IRS is raising the interest rate it charges on unpaid taxes, and further rate hikes are expected. Most people don't know it, but the IRS adds interest charges on your tax debt daily. So if you owe the IRS today, you will owe even more tomorrow. And it doesn't stop until you get right with the IRS. The good news is, getting right can start with one phone call to Optima Tax Relief, America's number one tax relief firm. Optima's tax professionals specialize in the Fresh Start Initiative, a powerful IRS program that can save you thousands if you qualify. In fact, the experts at Optima Tax have resolved over $1 billion in tax debt for their clients. Call now for a free consultation.
Call 800-480-6932. That's 800-480-6932. 800-480-6932.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
WIBX 950 and 106.9 FM. This is Keeler.
Tuesday morning and a beautiful one on the way. Sunshine 75 today or close to it. It's going to be really, really nice. And then we get very wet, very rainy, and cooler temperatures. I don't know. It's going to cool off. The next couple of days will be in the 60s. But if you look as the week goes on, are you ready?
As the week goes on.
I believe this is, Utica, Rome. All right, as the week goes on, your 10-day forecast. Of course, today, sunshine, high near 75. And then rain begins tonight, low 50 tomorrow, 62 rain. Thursday, 67 in rain. Friday, 61 in rain. And then get ready. Saturday, 46 and showers. Sunday, 58 and showers as we warm up back into the 60s for next week. But it's going to be a cool weekend. There's probably a chance you'll see a little wet snow somewhere this weekend. On the line right now is Sheriff Rob Maciol. Sheriff, good morning.
Good morning, guys. That's a very depressing forecast.
It is. Once you get through today, brutal.
Yep.
As the forecast stands right now, the next time after today we'll see sunshine will be a week from today on Tuesday.
That is awful.
Yeah. Huh. Now, think about this. Can you imagine when here we have, a beautiful weather today, but rain for the next 5 or 6 days. Could you imagine if the eclipse fell on one of these heavy rain days?
I'm sure there would have been some diehard people that would have still tried.
You're probably right. Yeah. So I got to tell you, I think all of the planning, and this isn't just not Oneida County, not your warnings that were out there. These warnings have been coming nationwide along the path of totality and certainly statewide. I do think it kind of scared people away, and they kind of found alternatives because they were worried about, heavy, heavy traffic. Because yesterday, our trip to Old Forge and back was not bad.
Yeah, I think that might be part of it, but also part the message that had been coming out from the get-go was to arrive early and stay late. So, we had people monitoring the hotel vacancy statuses, and a lot of the hotels, people that were going to stay arrived the day ahead of it, so which was good. We saw, I think the DOT briefing, when the phone conversation I had early yesterday morning, like Route 12 North had like a 20% bump in traffic, which was no big deal. I was up at our command post probably around 11 o'clock, but it was very similar to what your report was. I mean, traffic was flowing through the North Country, through the northbound of Route 12. As you approach the Elder Creek area where 12 and 28 intersect, clearly the traffic was bottlenecking but never came to a stop. And you're right. I assumed everyone was going to go to the right and take 28 into Old Forge, but it was probably 4-1 the amount of cars going left to Boonville as compared to right to Route 28.
I was really surprised by that.
Yeah, I there was an incredible amount of traffic for periods of time, but again, nothing serious. A couple minor little things here and there. But very, very well coordinated. Hats off to my people who coordinated with the New York State Police and New York State DOT. As you traveled north, you probably saw what was taking place. There were, teams of whether it be deputy sheriffs at different places located or members of the state police located at various points along the route. And most of them were two-man cars, and it was done that way. So if there was a bottleneck in traffic and there was, let's say, an accident, this team could quickly deploy. We also had ATVs available in case, there was a traffic bottleneck and we had to go up the shoulder of the road. We also had our full marine unit out. We had boats either in the water or ready to go in the water on Oneida Lake, Delta Lake, White Lake, Otter Lake, Cayuta Lake, and Hinckley Lake. Because, again, we wanted to make sure that if someone went out on the water to watch the eclipse, which some people did, that had boats. We didn't know what to expect, you know. So
yeah,
you know, some critics say we overprepared. Well, I'd rather be overprepared and have nothing happen than to be underprepared and have something happen. So, like, yeah, I said, hats off to my people that did all this planning. They did a great job.
And the overpreparation is something you can say you think was what happened, but you will never know, right?
Correct. That is correct.
That's the problem with that.
You know, it was a different vibe. I mean, it was a very family oriented. You know, I mean, typically. And there were spots here in Oneida County that, you know, we knew we're going to get some traffic, but certainly not the traffic that they saw. I mean, Star Hill, the parking area on Star Hill, and our friend Farmer Ben, that's where his place is. He had over 340 cars that were parked on his road. And that's a road which maybe sees one or two cars in an entire day drive through, let alone 340 cars parked there. You know, but again, people were out playing ball. The kids were playing ball, and some people were grilling some food and things like that. So it was really neat. I actually watched from the Adirondack Bank Center. I cleared the north detail, headed down in the afternoon to the Adirondack Bank Center. I watched there. The celebratory feeling was pretty cool. You know, everyone was in a great mood and just all very positive. And you know, I mean, hats off to this area. I know we say it all the time, but like I said, I was at the Adirondack Bank Center, you know, working the detail through the hockey game last night, and it was amazing. I mean, just to feel the energy that you don't normally feel, and it's like we were in a different place. It was almost like we went somewhere, you know, in an area that does this all the time, and it was, you know, but here we were right here in Utica. Yeah, it was pretty cool.
You know, think about the amazing thing that happened yesterday in this eclipse. If you're part of the hockey, if you're one of the people who've come into town, or if you're one of the players who have come into town, here you are at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and you're just at the edge of totality for a very rare solar eclipse. I mean, that was a pretty cool, as you said, cherry on the top for those people.
Absolutely. And there were people talking to me, and there was a gentleman from Minneapolis. He was a law enforcement member. He saw me in uniform, came up, introduced himself, and he said just that. He said, "My God, I'm here to watch this world hockey tournament.
I can see
the eclipse," he said. And it was actually at the time a really good, as you know, I'm a country music guy. There was a country music band playing, and this guy liked it too. He said, "I've got everything that I ever wanted to see. I'm in one place standing here in a place I never heard of before."
Yeah.
You know, and that's pretty cool.
That is really, really cool. So, again, it's one of those things where, you know, had you done, had there been no planning and just promoting this eclipse, you never know what kind of traffic you would have been dealing with. And
exactly.
I think people just found their convenient ways to be able to pull this thing off. Of course, you know, Sheriff, I don't think you should be surprised that my wife and I did exactly the opposite of what you had recommended. we left late and we went late and left early. So
right. Wow.
But it all, you know, listen, we had to come home last night we wanted to be home for the hockey game. And ultimately it all worked out. What an amazing couple of days this has all been between this and the I do think there's an element of people out there that are like, "Oh, give me a break. That eclipse was nothing. I mean, you people just keep blowing stuff up. It's just ridiculous." I was unbelievably impressed, and almost I don't want to say almost, I definitely was emotionally affected by what happened yesterday.
It was, you know, and you know, from the farm side of things, because I know you were asking about animals earlier today. My wife was off because school was closed yesterday, but my wife was home. My daughter-in-law, my grandson was here. He's only 2 months old, so he didn't really know what was going on. But
yeah.
But they watched the eclipse from here and from out back, and our cows are out and the horses. And she said the only thing the animals did, they didn't get nervous at all, but it was kind of funny because as soon as darkness set in, the horses and the cows went right to the gates. Like they wanted, it was time to come in.
Time
so they,
to come in.
For a second there, they thought it was nighttime because that's their routine here. As the sun begins to set, we go meet them at the gates and we bring everybody in. And that's the only thing that they did out of the ordinary. And then they went back to life as normal, life as usual after the daylight came back.
Well, so. It was the other part of it was really interesting is once that totality hit, how cool the temperature. I mean, it really dropped like 10 degrees, it felt like.
Yeah, that's what they said. Somewhere around 12 to 15 degree drop that they experienced. So
yeah, it was.
That was pretty neat.
Yep, no doubt. Pretty neat. All right, Sheriff, good stuff. So another one in the books.
Sounds great, guys. And we'll see everybody at hockey over the next few days here as we continue to move forward.
Sounds good. Thank you so much.
All right.
Take care. And the other thing is they've done a really tremendous job over there with the way everything is set up and organized, and you just can't you can't ask for much more than where we are with what's going on right now. It's going to be very interesting when all of this stuff is done. God forbid if the Pioneers don't make it into the playoffs. Utica City FC will, but it'll be
you mean the Comets.
It's going the Comets. I mean, it's going to be quiet, right?
It's all right because it'll be summertime, and people always find stuff to do in the summer.
That's a very good point.
And Utica City FC has their playoff game on Monday.
Yeah, so they'll
they
be
played yesterday. And they right, lost. Unfortunately, they lost.
As soon as this is over, they'll be in the playoffs. And you know, we always talk about how tomorrow the festivities begin. It's been going on all week if you're down there. But the Masters, the 88th Masters, teeing off Thursday morning with 89 players in the field vying for the green jacket. For those looking to cash in, are you ready? You want to know the odds?
Let's hear it.
These are the favorites. I wonder if these ever play out.
Let me ask you. Let me name three of them.
All right, I will. Okay, Davey, if you were to pick the top three, who would you pick?
Scotty Scheffler.
Yep.
John Rahm.
Yep.
Then I would go with Rory.
Those are the top three. Congratulations. Who's number one on that?
Scotty Scheffler.
That is true. Plus 450 to win, minus 105 to be in the top three, and minus 200 to be in the top five.
Well, Scheffler's the number one player in the world. John Rahm's the defending champ who hasn't even played on the PGA. He defected over to the LIV Golf. And Rory, he's looking for the career slam.
And Rory is plus 1,000 to win, number two, followed by plus 210 to be in the top three and plus 110 to be in the top five. John Rahm, plus 1,100. Brooks Koepka, plus 2,000. Jordan Spieth, plus 2,500.
Hideki Matsuyama
is plus 2,500 to win. And for the dreamers out there, are you ready? Tiger Woods is going off at 15,000.
So put 200
plus
on him.
15,000. If you put 200 and Tiger Woods won, you would win $30,000.
If
you put 100, you'd win
$15,000,
and of course, a $50 bet would get you $7,500.
So, if I put $200 on him to win, and he comes in the top three, is that a separate bet you'd have to make, or is that all
separate, inclusive? Yeah, it's a separate bet. You'd have to.
So
let me tell you what that is. For Tiger to land in the top three, this is very interesting. For Tiger to land in the top three, it's only plus $1,400. I mean, that's not far off from Rory. Rory is plus 1,000. So that's, I mean, let me say this. According to Vegas, the odds are better for Tiger Woods to make the top three than, no, that's, I was wrong. Sorry. No, I'm wrong. I'm reading the wrong thing. So for top three, plus 1,400 for Tiger. I'm thinking, wow, they think he's going to place in the top three, the top 500, or the top five. When in reality, no. So it's Rory is plus 210, Tiger is plus 1,400, Brooks Koepka is plus 330, and Tiger is plus 1,400 to be in the top three. But yeah, so if you wanted to say he'd be in the top three, a $100 bet would win you $1,400.
I'd be good with that.
Yeah, well, that'd be a good investment. except chances are
he won't make the cut.
He's not even going to make the cut, and you're blowing $100.
Tomorrow's the par three contest.
And what everybody gets in, does that give you any indicator? Like, would that give you an indicator on how Tiger's going to do, or does, what do you think?
Well, he's been there since Sunday, walking the grounds. He played a practice round on Sunday, and he played a practice round yesterday.
All right. All right, listen, much more to get to in about a half an hour to do it. So, stand by. We'll come right back at WIBX.
Tire and Auto Repair, your trusted tire experts. Let Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair get your vehicle ready for spring. Visit Tallman's to get your free alignment check and take advantage of their spring tire rotation and four-wheel balance special for only $39.99. Get the snow off now and save with an instant rebate on Bridgestone and Firestone tires in April, up to $100 off. Visit them in Utica, Yorkville, Rome, and Herkimer, or schedule an appointment online at tallmanstire.com.
Some stores will tell you they carry Purple Mattress, but they may only have two or three on the floor. Only Mattress Express has nine different purples on the floor. Stop into any Mattress Express store, try all the purples, and then we'll pull up the website and give you the same prices online.
Get ready for this week's half-off Thursday deal with SeizeTheDeal.com. Score your half-off gift certificate to Tom Cavallo's Restaurant this Thursday morning starting at 8 a.m. Get $50 for $25 with Seize the Deal's half-off Thursday. Tom Cavallo's Restaurant in New Hartford, known for their great daily specials, wings and great happy hours, trivia nights on Thursday, and legendary fish fries on Fridays. Online at Cavallo's.com. Get your half-off Thursday gift certificates this Thursday from Tom Cavallo's Restaurant. Hurry, they sell out fast at SeizeTheDeal.com.
We used to argue about whose turn it was to clean the gutters, but then I had Leaf Filter Gutter Protection installed.
Wait, I told you Leaf Filter had free inspections and estimates and a lifetime guarantee.
Meaning we never have to argue about whose turn it is to clean the gutters again.
But I visited LeafFilter.com/triumph first.
No, I did.
It doesn't matter who. Visit LeafFilter.com/triumph to schedule your free gutter inspection and get up to 30% off today.
See representative for warranty details. Promotion is 20% off plus a 10% senior or military discount. One discount per household.
If spring allergies keep you trapped inside, then you need Navage Nasal Care to keep you breathing clearly and enjoying all the beauties of spring. Navage helps clear nasal passages that are often clogged because of seasonal allergies. Navage gently flushes a pure, refreshing saline solution through your nasal passages to clear out congestion, sucking out that springtime pollen and other irritants trapped in your nose. Navage is available online at Navage.com or in stores at Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, and Target. Navage. N-A-V-A-G-E.
Did you know one of the best investments you can make? It's in yourself. At My Computer Career, in just a few months, you could start your new career in the high-demand, recession-resistant field of information technology. Isn't it time you invest in you and start a career in networking, cybersecurity, AI, or upskill to boost your current IT career? So, get the ROI you deserve at My Computer Career. No experience necessary. Start now at mycomputercareer.edu.
Financial aid is available for qualified students, including the GI Bill.
The spring floor sample sell-off is on at My Carl's. Floor samples of living room sets, dining sets, bedroom sets, prices slashed up to 70% off. Only at My Carl's in the New Hartford Shopping Center.
And 106.9 FM, The Keeler Show.
It was a beautiful day. The moon came over the sun.
It was a darkness.
It got cold. I burned my eyes. Yeah,
burned my
running
eyes.
Running down Genesee Street.
Andrew's looking at the sun.
Looking in the sun.
Okay, a few things. The Dusty Puppies this afternoon will be playing over at the Olympic Village today, I believe. Am I correct with that?
You are correct, Bill.
That's Dave Olney's band, and they're really good. If you get a chance to check them out. What else did I want to mention here?
Brian Miller's birthday. Happy birthday to the Assemblyman.
Assemblyman Brian Miller.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Let's see if I have some. I have some other comments here that I really have been missing a lot of the comments, and I apologize. We're stinking busy here. The problem is you got to hit 9 buttons to get one thing happening. Yeah. So that is a problem. By the way, Dusty Puppies 4-7 at the Subaru Olympic Village today. Joe Malachi, my house was directly on the line between totality and partial totality. So on one side of the street, it was completely dark, and the other side, it was still light. Very surreal and an amazing experience. That's really cool, Joe. Like, you should have, that would have been a great place for somebody to stand and decide what they were going to do. Am I going to do this, or am I going to do that? Have to make a decision. That is very cool, and Rome was right in the middle of a ton of it. Anne in Rome, great photo from 1980. How about that, Anne? She was a flower girl of the 80s.
If you're going to San Diego.
Well, that's where she was. What was banned in Indonesia for stimulating passion? That's from Donna.
Ooh. Donna's like our go-to trivia gal. Lately.
What was banned in Indonesia for stimulating passion?
Oh, my God.
What toy, I would say. Would we call this a toy? What toy was banned in Indonesia for stimulating, you know, for turning people on?
Oh, my God. I don't know.
The answer is the hula hoop. Apparently that that kind of got people gyrating a little bit.
A little bit.
Like, you remember Elvis.
Uh-huh.
They didn't like his gyrations.
That's how I practice, baby. How do you do the hula hoop?
There he is, Elvis. There. Joel Patterson is a workplace expert. Heads up the Vested Group, a firm that is always on the best places to work list. And the topic here is quiet quitting, coffee badging, what this new vocabulary says about your workplace. I don't even know what these things mean. I'm lost. Joel, good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing?
I would say that quiet quitting, can I guess? Quiet quitting is just not, just, it's either quitting respectfully and not putting it on YouTube or TikTok, or
just not showing up.
Or you're just like quietly disappearing.
The Irish goodbye.
Yeah.
It's really just doing the absolute minimum that you can do without getting fired.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which is not that difficult to think about, but you know, there's a lot of other ones. Rage applying. Have you heard that one yet? It's the act of applying to as many jobs as you possibly can in a very short amount of time.
Okay. And what do you get out of that?
Yeah, sometimes you get multiple offers, right?
I don't. Yes. Yeah, but also I feel like it's kind of like getting mad at somebody in traffic.
Yeah,
because everybody doesn't really know. Those other people don't really know that you're doing it. But
if you do that when you're and you're applying for credit cards, your score goes down. I wonder what happens with this. That's a gotta wonder. Yeah, a lot of these new things. There is a different world. This generation sees the world so differently than I almost feel like. Maybe every generation goes through this, Joel. I'd be wondering what research you've done, if any, on the history of the way, you know, we're going to work at home. You can't say that to me. You have no right to treat me this way. You can't work me this way. You have no right to do this. It's all that crap. It's a sensitive generation. Is this comparative to, you know, how the parents of the 50s felt about their kids when they went into the workplace in the 70s.
You know, I can't help but think that there is some glory days syndrome going on here.
Yeah,
you know, where we just feel like because we had to do it, they had to do it. But the difference is they're dealing with a completely different type of technologies. They've got, you know, just different, the pandemic. I mean, all of those things kind of played into it. And it's clearly a time of uncertainty for Gen Z specifically. And they're not as worried about climbing the corporate ladder as you or I may have.
Right.
You know, it's more, what do I get out of my experiences? Am I getting to learn? And do I have balance in my life where I feel like I've got time to go do the things that I want to do?
Yeah. Many young workers are passing on promotions because they value their free time more than they do titles or money. Interesting.
And it's hard to argue with that, right?
Yeah,
I mean, you know, that's the silver lining of some of these conversations is they really are bringing to light some things that maybe we didn't like as we were going through our careers, you know, as far as maybe we don't want to work 60 hours in a week.
Right.
And that's okay, too. It's just different. And sometimes change is a little bit difficult to handle.
Yeah, and I know the thing is while there are some things that have come to light, I still think there is this weird switch of not so much, you know, I hate to sound like a lesser version of Kennedy here, but not what you can do for the company, but what the company can do for you in a way. You know, how many vacation days am I getting? You know, how much time do I have off? You know, all that kind of stuff.
I got to tell you, as somebody who's been working for more than 40 years, I value vacation more than ever before.
Well, you've earned
that, and I find that out of the gate, these kids want that.
That is true. It is interesting, especially when you're interviewing ones that are just coming out of college or something. There are some expectations that are really high and really kind of not realistic, you know.
Yeah,
but they're willing to ask, and that's
right.
a different vibe as well. But recognizing that they don't necessarily always have those soft skills that maybe would keep them from asking for those things,
mm-hmm.
and investing in them in different ways than we have traditionally is really the key to keeping them satisfied.
Talking to Joel Patterson, a workplace expert, he's with the Vested Group, and they're always on the list of best places. So you got to be doing something right. Best places to work on that list. So. You know, I find, and maybe you can just walk me through this, I find, you know, I used to do a morning radio show that was kind of like we did crap. We did stuff. And from stunts that would get you arrested today to women in the studio, you know, they'd send up from Penthouse Magazine, one of their models, and all these guys would come in the studio, women coming in and flashing, all that crap that was going on. It was big in morning radio at that time. All of that would get you fired and destroyed today.
cancel.
Every bit of it. And I just find the environment is so different. I had a friend that said they work in a larger market where it's a metered market, and you literally can watch your audience, and they'll know each morning. If you did a bit at 8:30 and it wasn't going well, they'll be like, hey, don't do that again because the numbers went down. But when you start talking about anything porn, strippers, all that Stern stuff that used to go on, the numbers plummet today, even with a male audience. That's interesting, I think.
That is interesting. I'm not sure how to correlate that.
Well, here's where I'm
going with Gen Z.
Here's where I'm going.
No nudeness in the workplace.
Here's where I'm going, and I guess I just was fair enough. But where I'm going is what you can and cannot say in the workplace. It can be very difficult for somebody who's 50, dealing with a bunch of people who are in their 20s. All of a sudden, you know, you're calling someone sweetheart and. Hey, that's not appropriate today. There's just there's a lot of things that this new generation is as they really take control of the workplace. It's got to be an eye opener for somebody older.
Oh, it definitely is. I mean, I get caught in that stuff all the time. Even here's a good one for you. Did you know that out of pocket doesn't mean you're just away? It means you kind of gone crazy. You know, I mean, you went out of pocket over the weekend. Something as simple as that. Means something completely different to the newer generation than it does to you and me. And there's those things pop up every day.
Yeah. But somebody says out of pocket to you, you're reaching in your pocket, give them a 20. Like, you need this?
Again? More money?
All right. Well, listen, how does one, how do you, what can you do? How do you learn? How do you learn to do it right and not offend somebody? What's the best way that you advise?
I mean, I think it's just being intentional. It's not that complicated. It's just recognizing that hey, treat everybody as an individual. At least pay attention to what's going on and try not to get yourself into those weird situations. But I really believe that if you just recognize that it's a little bit different, you invest in them as best as you can, you communicate and you treat them fairly, you're going to be just fine. It doesn't mean there's not bad apples out there, because there are.
Yeah,
there's a lot of good ones, too.
All right, good stuff. Interesting. Joel, sorry to go off sidetrack, but I will tell you, Tina Desire is coming up next on the program. She's in studio. It's going to be a good time.
There goes the audience.
All right, Joel. Have a great day.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks so much. I think I went off the rails there. I don't know. But you know what? You know where I was going with it is just like,
yeah.
I'm the stuff we could do, the stuff you were expected to do back then just would not fly today. And maybe that's good, right? Maybe
I think so.
Maybe that's good. Although there are those, man, I love those old days. Well, maybe it's good that those old days aren't around. But it comes right down to even, and we've been in a scenario before, where you have someone who is like, well, you're not being emotional enough. You're not thinking about my feelings when you told me I have to do that. I do think you get to the point where you don't know what you can and cannot say to somebody today.
Yeah, it's tough. That's why it's just best to say nothing at all.
That's why
just
here's
not.
How.
Yes,
that's,
no. Yes,
that's
no.
Why on this program, I just want to tell you, we went from Christine and then Andrew left. And then Andrew came back and Christine left. Jeff was still there. Davey's always been there. Christine left and then Jeff left. And then Andrew came back because he'd left. I forgot to tell you. And then Andrew left. Jeff came back. If you notice, it's been kind of a bit of a revolving.
Yeah, corporate
but
loves
everybody,
that.
But everybody's, because you become comfortable with somebody. I'm not a big fan of having new people, which is why we've really worked with the same four people on this program over the last 12 years. Think about that. They come, they leave, but they always seem to come back. They leave, but they come back. All right, we'll wrap up this craziness coming up here. Me and you, Davey, though, we've been constant.
Yeah.
8:51 at WIBX.
And my team at Standard Heating, Cooling, and Insulating can help. Through the Empower New York program, we've helped thousands of people qualify for completely free insulation and heating upgrades, bringing energy savings to over 6,500 homes in our area. If you qualify for HEAP or SNAP, you're halfway there already. We can help reduce your energy bills while making your home more comfortable, all for free. Call us today at 315-859-6292. We promise to save you money.
Fraudulent tax returns due to identity theft increased by 30% in 2023. If you're in a bind this tax season, LifeLock can help. Their U.S.-based restoration specialists are dedicated to helping solve identity theft issues, and all plans are backed by the $1 Million Protection Package, which means if you lose money because of identity theft, LifeLock will reimburse you up to the limits of your plan. Help protect your information with LifeLock. Go to LifeLock.com and save up to 25% your first year with my name, Clay, as your promo code.
If spring allergies keep you trapped inside, then you need Navage Nasal Care to keep you breathing clearly and enjoying all the beauties of spring. Navage helps clear nasal passages that are often clogged because of seasonal allergies. Navage gently flushes a pure, refreshing saline solution through your nasal passages to clear out congestion, sucking out that springtime pollen and other irritants trapped in your nose. Navage is available online at Navage.com or in stores at Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, and Target. Navage, N-A-V-A-G-E.
Ready for a smoother, safer ride? Look to Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair, your trusted tire experts. Let Tallman's Tire and Auto Repair get your vehicle ready for spring. Visit Tallman's to get your free alignment check and take advantage of their spring tire rotation and four-wheel balance special for only $39.99. Get the snow off now and save with an instant rebate on Bridgestone and Firestone tires in April, up to $100 off. Visit them in Utica, Yorkville, Rome, and Herkimer, or schedule an appointment online at tallmanstire.com.
On YouTube, we showed, I'm going to do it again coming up here, a picture of the total solar eclipse yesterday at the exact time of totality. At the moment there that it became really dark, and it was incredible. This is in Tupper Lake. The photo is up on YouTube right now if you're watching on YouTube, or you go back and watch it. Towards the end of the show, you'll see it, like right now. And it is a picture taken by Dr. Kent Hall. Isn't that a beautiful picture?
That's like one that you would get from like Getty or one of the professional wire services.
That's really, really good. I'm going to use it. I love it. And it's up on it's up there on YouTube right now. You can check that out. The other day we had I'm working on a little bit with this. There was another airline passenger meltdown that happened on Spirit. Someone who was on the plane posted the woman overreacting. They're saying overacting. While three deputies are trying to take her off the flight for being disruptive. Even though she says she'll go, she didn't. And they had to get everybody off the plane because of it. I want to play this clip again. Listen to this woman. And at one point, what did she say? Stop calling me a... acting like a...
Like I'm a rascal.
Like you're acting like a rascal or something like that. Check
She's
it out.
She's calling herself.
I can walk out on my own. You don't need to. Why are you doing that?
Walk out.
Why are you acting like I'm a rascal?
Why are you acting like I'm a rascal? Yeah,
that's
really?
The lady from the last time.
I only wonder if it would be possible, and I don't know that it would be, but I only wonder if it would be possible for me to put this into our, we have a our system, if you will.
Oh, yeah, your secret weapon.
And I would wonder if maybe, I could remove all the other audio that's there, and we could isolate that clip and use it. So, right? I'm trying to do it, and I can't seem to get it off. But here it is. So I'm going to put it over here and drop it there.
Put it in the old desktop.
That's right there. I'm going to move it into – it'll just show you how amazing software is today and what it can actually do. Now I'm going to bring her audio in. And let's see if we can play it. I'm going to try to play it, and then I'm going to try to remove everybody else in the clip. Let's see what happens.
I can walk out on my own. You don't need to.
Okay,
why
out.
Are you doing that?
Walk out.
Why are you acting like I'm a rascal?
Why are you acting like I'm a rascal? Who would say such a thing, right?
A drunk person.
Who would say something? All right, let's see if we can eliminate some of the noise and change the clip a little bit.
All right, here we go.
I can walk out on my own. You don't need to.
Okay,
I don't know.
It's a little better.
Why are you doing that?
How about now?
Are you acting like I'm a rascal?
All right, that's a little better. I've got her almost isolated completely, right?
Yeah.
A little
rascal.
Here it is.
Why are you acting like I'm a rascal?
I think it works.
Why are you acting like I'm a rascal?
I think I can play with it. All right, listen, that's it. We have a just, I would warn you, please, take advantage of today. I know the weather's been in the news because we've been dealing with this eclipse. And imagine if today's weather was yesterday. Yeah, but imagine if tomorrow's weather was yesterday. We're going to get a lot of rain over the course of the next 4 or 5 days. But today is going to be just unbelievable. The National Weather Service is predicting an unbelievably beautiful day today with mostly sunny skies, a few afternoon clouds, and a high near 75 degrees. Enjoy it, and then the rain comes. Enjoy your day.
Cold this winter? Call Tri-County Heating and Air Conditioning for your free furnace estimate. Smart folks choose Rood energy-efficient heating equipment for their home. Call Tri-County Heating and Air Conditioning at 315-829-4100, 315-829-4100, or visit their website at tri-countyheating.com. Turn that thermostat down with your Rood high-efficiency furnace and stay warm this winter. 315-829-4100 or tri-countyheating.com.
Adirondack Home Furniture wants you to get your savings in full eclipse mode at their Total Eclipse Sale. Don't miss out on stellar deals that are out of this world. It's their best prices of the year. Take an extra 15% off all in-stock and special orders and 10% off all clearance items. Adirondack Home Furniture is fully stocked for this event, with merchandise arriving daily. With free delivery on purchases over $1,000 and a knowledgeable staff, you'll have your stellar home in no time. Adirondack Home Furniture has a
large line of quality USA-made furniture from top manufacturers. Their salespeople are non-commissioned, which means you enjoy a relaxing, non-stressful experience. Stop in today to Adirondack Home Furniture and check out their stellar deals with their total eclipse sale going on now. Living rooms, dining rooms, bedrooms, and more, all at the best prices of the year. Adirondack Home Furniture at Riverside Center in North Utica or at AdirondackHomeFurniture.com.
Replacing your roof isn't a decision you take lightly. You want industry standards met with affordable options and a crew who knows how important a sound roof is to you and your family. That is Padula & Sons Roofing is your hometown roofers with deep roots in our community. Padula Roofers specialize in residential roofing projects. They're a GAF certified master elite roofing contractor who keeps their standards above the rest. Call 315-733-1564 to find out more about their Roofs for Troops mail-in rebate. That is Padula & Sons Roofing, your hometown roofers.
They are paying for what their son did. I'm Dave Anthony, Fox News. Sentencing is this hour in Michigan for James and Jennifer Crumbly, the first parents held criminally responsible for a school shooting, convicted of involuntary manslaughter for not doing enough to treat their son's mental illness and providing the gun Ethan used to murder four classmates at Oxford High in 2021.
Prosecutors are seeking a sentence of up to 15 years for each parent, and they say the crux of remorse. The parents did stand trial separately, but they are expected to be sentenced together today. Mrs. Crumbly's attorney is asking for leniency. She's even offering to let her client live in her guest house instead of going to prison.
Fox's Brooke Singman, Ethan Crumbly's is behind bars for life. Breaking news out of Ohio, a settlement in last year's fiery and toxic train derailment that still has residents of East Palestine concerned about contamination. Norfolk Southern has agreed to pay $600 million to residents who were part of a class action lawsuit. An 18-year-old from Idaho busted facing terror charges.
Court documents unsealed on Monday by the Department of Justice say Alexander Mercurio was one day away from a planned attack on churches in his hometown of Coeur d'Alene, Idaho, when he was arrested on Saturday. Mercurio is accused of telling an FBI source